we mention the story of coming of Jibril عليه السلام to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم in the cave of Hira, that he was squeezing the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم too much. He was pressing on the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, and the scholar said that he was telling him that you are about to be inspired with a heavy message. You are about to be inspired with a heavy da'wah. And this is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran exactly in Surah Al-Muzzammil. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in Surah Al-Muzzammil, Ya ayyuhal Muzzammil, O you who covers himself or wraps himself in clothing, قُمِ اللَّيْلَ إِلَّا قَلِيلًا, arise to pray at night except a little, نصفه أو انقص منه قليلا, half of it or subtract from it a little, أو زد عليه or add to it, ورتل القرآن ترتيلا, and recite the Quran with a measured recitation. إنا سنلقي عليك قولا ثقيلا, إنا سنلقي عليك قولا ثقيلا, we will cast upon you a heavy word. يعني now Allah سبحانه وتعالى يعني he prepares the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم for this great message. Allah سبحانه وتعالى prepares his messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم to this heavy invitation, this heavy دعوة, and Allah سبحانه وتعالى prepares the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم by praying at night, to order him to pray at night, to have more iman, to add an action or acts of worship. Because of what? Because we will cast upon you a great message, a heavy word. You receive something that it's very hard. It's not easy. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prepares the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم for the difficult days, the difficult future that يعني, he will face many troubles, he will face many hardships in his life. After he announces that he is a prophet, this is the time that you are going to start to face many troubles in your life because of this da'wah. طيب, we said that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or Angel Jibreel عليه السلام, came to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم and he recited to him the first verses of Surah Al-Alaq. And the first word that was revealed to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, it was Iqra, read. What is the meaning of Iqra? It means read. Iqra, Bismi Rabbika الذي خلق. Read in the name of your Lord who created. The word read, it means to read from a paper, right? And there is another meaning, you may read from your memory. When Jibreel came to the Prophet ﷺ, he thought that he meant in the paper sense. Jibreel عليه السلام, he meant when he said to the Prophet, read, he meant in a paper sense, in the paper sense. But he meant, the angel Jibreel عليه السلام, he meant in the sense from his memory, from the memory of the Prophet. Read from your memory, because Jibreel عليه السلام knows that the Prophet عليه السلام, he cannot read from the paper, because he doesn't know how to read or write. He didn't study. And Allah سبحانه وتعالى says to him, اقرأ or read in the name of your Lord who created. Why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions in this verse his name, read in the name of your Lord. اقرأ بسم الله, بسم ربك, in the name of Allah. When you recite in the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. To tell, the angel Jibreel, he came with this message, with this revelation, with this surah, with this ayat, to tell him that this Quran is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, not from any other one. It's only from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He tells him that the Quran is the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That these ayat are the ayat coming to you from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, not from anyone else. It's not from angel Jibreel. It's not from any other angel. It's not from humans. And to tell people that this Quran is the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. أَفَلَا يَتَدَّرُونَ الْقُرْآنَ وَلَوْ كَانَ مِنْ عِنْدِ غَيْرِ اللَّهِ لَوَجَدُوا فِيهِ اخْتِلَافًا كَثِيرًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah An-Nisa, أَفَلَا يَتَدَّرُونَ الْقُرْآنَ. Don't they reflect upon the Quran? وَلَوْ كَانَ مِنْ عِنْدِ غَيْرِ اللَّهِ. If it was from anyone, if it had been from anyone other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, لَوَجَدُوا فِيهِ اخْتِلَافًا كَثِيرًا. They would have found within it too much contradiction. If the Quran, it is not the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, يعني, it's normal that you see many differences, many contradictions, you see many mistakes, but the Quran, there is no mistakes in the Quran. There is no any other mistake. There is no anything wrong in the Quran. All the Quran is right. يعني, if someone wrote something from the Quran to you and to tell you that the Quran has some mistakes, this means that you have to study and read to know that and to discover the reality. And the reality that the Quran doesn't have any mistakes. Ever, never, you cannot find any mistakes in the Quran. If someone told you something like this, this means that you have to study to know. This means that it's your fault. It's not the fault of the Quran. It's not the fault of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Jibreel alayhi salam, he told يعني, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as this message from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, اقرأ بسم ربك الذي خلق, the first verse as we mentioned. اقرأ بسم ربك الذي خلق, خلق الإنسان من علق. He created man from that which clings. يعني, he tells the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم also that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he affirms that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created man. And it is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that he speaks with you. It is the one that he created. It is the one that he created humans. It is the one that he revealed the Quran. He is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one who speaks to you. It is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to affirm this reality. طيب, now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions in this ayat, اقرأ بسم ربك الذي خلق, read, خلق الإنسان من علق, اقرأ, again. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the third verse, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions, اقرأ. Again, this is the second time, يعني the first verse Allah says, اقرأ. بسم ربك الذي خلق, خلق الإنسان من علق. Then اقرأ وربك الأكرم. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala repeats the word اقرأ. The first verse, the third verse revealed in the Quran, both of them they have the word اقرأ. Well, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions the word اقرأ twice. It's a kind of confirmation that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala affirm that يعني, you have to read. But there is something else. There is a, يعني, a good hint in this word. And this hint that يعني, repetition in the Quran, when you see some repetitions in the Quran, it means that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala يعني, focus more and more, and that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants to affirm and confirm this meaning. Now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala confirms this meaning, the meaning of reading or recitation. There is also something else, as I said, and it's related to that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us, read, then read, don't stop reading. يعني, when you are graduate from high school, don't see that you have a great knowledge. Read. When you are graduated from the university, don't stop reading. Read after university. When you have a master's degree, don't stop reading. When you have a PhD degree, don't stop reading. When you are a professor, don't stop reading. When you see that you have يعني, bulk of knowledge or a great knowledge, don't stop reading. Don't stop reading till you die. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala repeats the meaning. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala underscores this meaning. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala clarifies to us. We have to read. And one of our problems as Muslims is that we don't read. It's very easy that someone may say some conceptions about you as Muslim and you cannot respond to him because you didn't read. This is a problem that many of us don't read. Sometimes people, he got a PhD degree, now خلاص, he's a scholar and there's no need to read. He made some research and then he became a professor in the university, there is no need to read. No. Read until you die. This is a reality that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or the fact that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants to affirm from those verses to read. We see that sometimes that many of us, we have libraries or we have hundreds of books or thousands of books and we don't read any of them. They are on the shelf and we look at them. We are very happy because we have a great library, but we don't read. We don't read about, مثلا, tafsir al-Qur'an, interpretation of the Qur'an, about the life of the Prophet, about the hadith of the Prophet, about the religions, different religions, about misconceptions about Islam. We have kind of shortcomings related to our religion. Believe me, if we read a lot about Islam, we will learn more and more. And also the same, it's not only related to Islam, to the knowledge regarding Islam or our religion. But if you are at university, read in your major. It's normal to do this. And we are required to do this. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you knowledge of something related to medicine, related to science, related to math or different things, related to physics or anything else, you have to read more and more to know different discoveries, different new information about this major that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you. That's why it is said that al-ilmu bahrun laysa lahu sahil. Knowledge is like a sea without a coast. Every time you read, you learn something new. Every time you study, you read, even in the Quran. مثلا, you memorize, if you memorize the Quran, and you memorize the Quran, let's say, in elementary school, 11 years old, 10 years old, or 12 years old, and you recite the Quran more and more, believe me that you will find, every time you read from the Quran, you will learn something new. But you read it to understand, not only just not just reading, that normal reading, that you read something that you like, like reading a book, any other book, but read the Quran to understand. Read the Quran to reflect upon the ayat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and you will find something different. That's why it is said that I heard this from Sheikh Salman al-Uda, that a man, he mentioned this short story. There was a man or a scholar on the pulpit, on the member. And then a man came to him, فَسَأَلَهُ رَجُلٌ سُؤَلًا. A man came to him and asked him a question. And then this scholar, he was on the pulpit, on the member, and he told him, I don't know the answer. لا أعلم. فقال الرجل ليس هذا مقام لا أعلم. Now you became a scholar. It's not allowed for you to say I don't know. Then this smart scholar said to him, إنما علوت بقدر علمي ولو علوت بقدر جهلي لبلغت عنان السماء. إنما علوت بقدر علمي. I had this rank of knowledge, or this great rank, this high position. I became a scholar because of the level of knowledge that I have. ولو كنت أو لو علوت بقدر جهلي لبلغت عنان السماء. If I was ignorant, I would reach the heights of the sky. Because many, many people, he means that many people of the ignorant, they have high positions. They don't deserve this, but they have high positions. But because I'm a scholar, I told you that I don't know. I have to be humble. Because this is the sense of knowledge. When you have knowledge, don't say, I'm a scholar, I'm a great scholar. No one knows like me. I have master degree, I have PhD degree, I reach a level of knowledge that no one did like me. If you have knowledge, if you are a scholar, if you are a scientist, this means that you have to be humble. Knowledge teaches us how to be humble. That's why you have, you can say that, you can see many people, they don't have knowledge, but they'd like to speak. They'd like to speak more and more. They'd like to prove that they are scholars, but they are not. That they have knowledge, but they are not. Don't speak about yourself that I am a scholar. Let your knowledge speaks about you. Your situations speaks about you. But don't, when you speak, don't speak like this. We learn from Islam how to be humble. We learn from Quran how to be humble. We learn from knowledge of that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us to be humble. And there is no problem because sometimes we have this problem is that when you ask someone and he says to you that I don't know, yani when you look at him you say that khalas, yani he doesn't have any knowledge. No, we have to respect the one who said that I don't know. من قال لا أعلم فقد أفتى. Yani when you say I don't know, this means that you give a fatwa that you don't know, you don't have the knowledge. That's why it said that يعني الإمام مالك رحمه الله يعني it said that يعني as I remember that if like 80 issues came to him to give a fatwa, he was saying fatwa for only one, and the other 79 he stops eating, he stops giving fatwa about them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the point here is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, read and read and read, don't stop reading. Or he tells us, tells his ummah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells the ummah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, don't stop reading, don't stop having knowledge, don't stop getting the knowledge from different majors or different fields. It's not surprise that like 200 years after, 200 years later, is that you see that the Muslims or Islam became the pinnacle of science, the pinnacle of medicine, the pinnacle of math. And the people from England and France, they used to go to Spain, Al-Andalus. It was under the rule of Muslims for 800 years. They used to go to Muslims in Andalusia or Spain, when it was under the authority of Muslims, to learn, to study, and to get this knowledge and go back to their countries to teach the people. Muslims were scholars and scientists in different fields. And now you can find this. You can find that many Muslims here in America or in Europe, many Muslims, they go to the university, they have master degree, PhD degree, they teach, they are professors, and they in different fields. They have the knowledge and they teach others. Because this is the message of Islam. The message of Islam, the great message of Islam, or the from the very first moment, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us to learn and study. And subhanallah, yani in the past, Adam alayhi salam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has taught him. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala taught him how to speak. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, يعني, even when this incident that it was between Habil and Qabil, when Qabil killed Habil, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as he mentions in Surah المائدة فبعث الله غرابا يبحث في الأرض ليريه كيف يواري سوءة أخيه. Allah سبحانه وتعالى has sent a crow to him to show him how to hide the disgrace of his brother, how to bury him. Allah سبحانه وتعالى يعني sent a crow to teach him how to bury his brother. Allah سبحانه وتعالى taught Idris عليه السلام to write using the pen. It is said that Idris عليه السلام he was the first one to use the pen, to write using the pen. The first one. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has taught Nuh alayhi salam how to build a ship. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has taught his prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells the prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam from those first verses of the Quran that he pledged to preserve the Quran, preserve his book. This book is not gonna be fabricated, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has pledged to. It's not like any other book. It's not like previous books. This book is a Quran is different. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take a pledge to himself that he will preserve it. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, Inna nahnu nazzalna al-dhikra وَإِنَّا لَهُ لَحَافِظُونَ. We see that we mentioned that the Prophet ﷺ was very scared when he saw Angel Jibreel عليه السلام in his massive form. He was scared and he went to his wife Khadija. He didn't go to his uncle. He was very close to his uncle. But this shows or clarifies to us how close was the Prophet ﷺ to his wife Khadija رضوان الله عليه. He could have gone to Abu Talib, his uncle, but he didn't do this. He went to his wife, Khadija Ridwanullahi alayha. And then, inshallah, next time, inshallah, we'll start to talk about the da'wah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what it's known as al-da'wah al-khassa or al-da'wah al-siriyah, but it wasn't a secret, it was private, it wasn't a secret. And it lasted for 3 years. Inshallah, we'll continue next time. نسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يوفقنا لما يحبه ويرضاه. قل قولي هذا أستغفر الله لي ولكم وجزاكم الله خيرا والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.